Hello, welcome to Maths with Jay.
Let's start by writing this recurring decimal down so that we can see what it really is. The dot is on the 3 and there's another one on the 5, so it means that the part that's recurring is just the 315. So this is 0.2315315315 and so on. It's only the 315 that is repeating. And just as we did with the simpler example, what we're going to do here is use algebra. So we can use any letter we like here. So let's just say y is equal to this decimal fraction. And then we have a look at how many digits are repeating. So 315, that's a group of 3 digits. And then I write down 3 zeros after 1. So that tells me I have got to multiply that fraction by 1,000. So what I'm really doing is moving the decimal point 3 places. So multiplying my decimal fraction by 1,000 gives me 231, so that's 231, and then 531, 531, 5315, and so on. So now you can see, if I do a subtraction on both sides, on the left hand side, 1000y minus 1y gives me 999y. And here's the trick, because on the right hand side, hopefully you can see by the way I've lined up these numbers, when we subtract the bottom number from the top, we end up with a very simple answer. So most of the right-hand side cancels out, doesn't it? The 315, 315, and so on cancels out. So all we need to do is 5 minus 2 gives us 3. That's going to be the decimal part. And the 231 stays the same. So we've got 231.3 on the right-hand side. So now we know that we can write y as, dividing both sides by 999, we can write y as 231.3 divided by 999. So that kind of looks like a fraction, but we've got a decimal in it, so that's not really a good idea, is it? So what I'm going to do first of all, to get rid of that decimal point, I'm going to multiply numerator and denominator by 10. So we've got 2,313 over 9,990. So I've just multiplied top and bottom by 10 there. And now we can cancel this fraction down. Let's have a look. So obviously 9 goes into the denominator, and when we add together the digits in the numerator, we get 2 plus 3 is 5, plus 1 is 6, plus 3 is 9. So 9 goes into that as well. So let's divide numerator and denominator by 9. So obviously 9's into 9 goes 1, so that's an easy one to do first. And then dividing 9 into the numerator, we get 9's into 23's into 18 twice, and so on. We will get 257, and I think that is as far as that will go. And then we of course want to check our answer. How would you do that?